Well, it's been hard work. You might just struggle with some of the conditions. Finally paid off.
Come on, sit down if you want to see
our mum. They're being the beast.
Oi!
You
can bugger
off.
Oi,
bugger
off.
That's alright, they're alright. It's a drop
just
inch.
Just let it go, Anne, it'll be alright.
Jesus Christ, man, I thought that broke.
It gets everybody.
You want to? As he looks, I'm going to try and fix it.
No, it's a drop inch.
What are you on about? That's €70 right
yeah.
there.
Yeah, €50.
Cool, I'm right up your nostril here. Look. I'm playing on you now all the time.
This camera really picks up your crevices, love.
Hold on, I swear.
You want me to put on 100
soon? No,
that's
seriously, 100. Yeah. Yeah.
I'll get Ashley to negotiate for me.
she better play out in the summer on the grass, in it, wouldn't she?
Yeah, it's not for me, obviously, it's boobies for Ashley.
I mean, you know.
She loves that game.
It does actually look a little bit like an action man, doesn't it?
More like Barbie's dad.
Ken's gay cousin.
What are you doing there?
I can see it going around.
That's a very...
It's gone. Oh, don't do that. Do it again. Boom. Just want to hit back myself.
Send you a message.
Is somebody here?
Is that what she said?
I'm assuming it's not Andy.
She's got things to ask.
Mind your way, Billy.
Don't worry about me.
That's my left one.
down a bit if you want, Mel. Rough it in a little bit. You can draft the rest.
Put it down, yeah?
Yeah, put it down. Oh. Might want to turn around. Just turn the cradle around once. Yeah.
Looking straight ahead, mate, because I'll move round you, so don't do that.
What are you taking my picture for? I put it down, boys.
I feel wanted. Right. Lift it up a slight bit more.
Is that right, Bill?
Yeah, I'm losing it. Phil, put it down. Oh.
Right, are they looking alright?
Yeah, I think they're alright, mate. It's the first time I've used that light as a...
Are they coming out now? They look alright, mate. Seriously, that first one you had there looked alright. At the end of the day, I think at night it's as good as we can get them, innit?
Nah,
go on, you're alright, I'm watching. What a beautiful specimen.
Thank you very much, fish isn't too bad either.
Come on. We want more.
And we will.
Look at that, girl.
What were we on that? 30?
37.
That's beautiful, eh?
Spot on, Mr. C.
What's the time?
21 minutes past one.
So 20 past one, Monday morning. Mr. C, what you had?
37 pound, bang on. Lovely mirror.
Snowman?
On the snowman, yeah. Over by the...
So that was an essential cell bottom bait. And what's the white pop-up? Is it a binocular?
Cell.
Oh, a cell pop-up, yeah?
White cell, one. Yeah.
Oh, the ones you bought...
off of Andy.
Yeah. Oh, happy days.
Yeah. Well, happy.
Royston?
I'm all. A bit bright there, mate.
Oh, you know, everyone says that.
That's fine. That's a little bit better.
I need to be able to actually see you on the video.
Hold on, mate. Let me move back and you can have it bright. I don't want to get a tan.
Well, you got your legs out for it.
I have, mate, yeah.
I'm trying to... Just... There we go. Because you were
chilling.
You were shouting at me, weren't you?
Yeah, again.
I was asleep.
Yeah, past the kid.
It was. Yeah. Quarter past 12. I was having an early night. Was the plan. Catch up on a bit of sleep.
I reckon you were just trying to ignore us.
Like I said, if it had been you...
If it had been me, you'd have gone at least another 20 minutes.
If not more.
You wouldn't have got up.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like.
Really, you had a fish. You should have given me a shout.
Yeah, well, we did.
You should have
I
said.
Know.
Should have said.
So, it's cup of tea, celebratory tea.
Yeah.
Celebratory wacko bar from Mr. C.
Is it wacko or wacko?
It's wacko. Okay.
We do have to point out as well that Roy made a tea again.
I did, yeah.
He did.
Well,
you were getting changed and we know we ain't going to make it.
No.
Actually, I think you made two today.
Three. I've done three. Oh, maybe that was the other day, though. two today, one and yesterday.
One, yeah, yeah. So it's three in total, which is
better than last year.
It's two up on last year.
Yeah, it's doing well. And it's only Monday morning. It's only Monday morning.
But it's my limit, basically. There will be no more. Get them out of the way early. Yeah, my load has gone.
But,
Boy, you've just dropped your rig box, mate.
And the cup's there, boy.
Keep calm, let number one make the tea.
Yeah, with that, I think we'll we'll end.
I see.
Because I'm going to want some sleep soon as well. good morning. Monday morning. It is 9:15. Literally, I have just got up, woken up by a nice cup of tea by Mr. Calder. I don't know who made it. Probably Roy, maybe. I don't know. But yeah, a bit of a late start this morning after that little interlude at 1 o'clock or whatever, 12:15, I think he actually had the fish. But we didn't go back to bed till about 1:30. And then I woke up again at 3:00, 3:30. But I'm just sitting watching the lake. It's a lovely morning. Sun's out. Not a lot of wind. And it looks really, really nice. Unfortunately, I've had no beeps, nothing. I have backleaded them two rods that were, the lines were slowly lifting on. I think that has solved the problem somewhat. But still no joys for me yet. I'm glad Neil's off the mark, it's always good. So Neil and Roy are both one under their belt each, well, two for Roy. And now it's me, I've got to get going now. I need to concentrate just a little bit more on what I'm doing on my fishing. So, you know, it's nice doing all the camera work and the pictures and that. I mean, I like doing that. But it's a lot of added work and people say to me about, you know, it's not really work, is it? You're still fishing and stuff like that, but I think you don't realise sometimes just all the other stuff that's going on in your head as far as, well, that'd be a nice shot, get a video of this, get a video of that, and you're trying to plan stuff so that you guys can watch something half decent. And so far, and it's Monday, in my head I don't feel like I've done hardly any video. So I'm going to try and get a lot of video done, try and obviously capture everything that goes on this week. But I need to start concentrating on my fishing. I'm fishing effectively, not really changing too much from how that I would normally fish, apart from using the boat to put out a couple of the rods. But when I'm normally fishing, there's not a lot of time that I spend away from the rods or the bivvy or watching my water. Here, it's completely different. Obviously, I go down there, sit with the boys, and I'm not sitting in my bivvy just staring out from the rods and thinking plans and stuff like that. So, I need to concentrate on my fishing for a little bit. Get a fish. So I'm going to sit here for a little bit. We'll go down and see the boys in a minute, thank them for the tea. And obviously catch up with the going on. Breakfast will be down, I should imagine, in a little while. But today I'm going to try and think about it a bit more. I may make some new rigs. And I'll do them on camera. There'll be the normal rigs that I've probably already done videos for, but I'll show you the components I'm using and how I do my rigs. Again, they're not probably going to be a lot different from anyone else, although they may be slightly different. People like to do different knots or whatever. At the moment, like I say, I'm just sitting in the doorway on my carpet, looking over the water, not watching, well, not seeing a lot, and hoping that one of them rods kicks off. So in fact, I think I'll put my bins on, try and look intelligent, the boy from Essex that's got no brains, and just take it all in for a bit, and then I don't know, I'll do some more video of maybe me doing a rig or me sorting out some bait or show you my stick mix, do something. Right now, I'm just going to enjoy it. Is that stripped back?
It's stripped back a bit more. I'd need to, I'll dry it, take the putty off, dry it, and try and get it back on again. But yeah, I've stripped it back about. Does it move forward again?
See, because where you want it is just sitting like that. Because then, obviously,
right,
it so can do that. So, where's the...
Let me start again. Remember on Neighbours? A little bit of trouble for the product placement. Sponsored by Cookie.
Because that can do that. See, that's how you want it to sit, or I would want it to sit, is like that. See, because then if a fish comes in anyway, wherever that sucks it in, that can do that, can just spin.
So what if I go, if I put a smaller boilie on?
Well, you can put your big boilie on, and sometimes when you trim it up, because you're making it a less round shape,
mm-hmm.
but it's also releasing flavours better, because you've opened
it up
to the porous or the bits that can really give out the oils or whatever. Do you just put one on top of the other, or do you flatten it off?
What's that, the things?
Like the do you flatten the bottom bait slightly and then flatten the pop ups so they fit together nice?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. They're,
yeah. So if you could really in essence flatten the bottom bait a lot more.
Yeah, yeah.
But I like trimming that round, because then it looks like it's all a bit, it's not normal, it's not round, it's not completely round, you know.
Unique.
Well, yeah, it's like, it's not like, because for a carp, you assume a visual aid is, well, that's round. That's what I've been caught on. That's round. So if it's slightly trimmed about and that, and sometimes obviously even if you make it look more square, so like a pellet shape, where they're fed pellet or whatever, then maybe they'll be a bit more acceptable to just not even thinking about it. And that's what you try to do, is just disengage that, oh, that could be a dodgy one. Whereas pellet, I doubt there's many people that fish pellet straight off, like as a hook bait. Mm. So they see something that's a bit more sort of squarish, if you like, and they go, oh, that's not to worry about. So you're just disengaging that worry sort of it, but that's the thinking in my eyes, right? I mean, obviously, even the pop-ups are still round as such, but I mean, you can trim that as well. It's kind of, you know, you mess about them both, and so you do that, and then just trim some of the sides to make it less round. So just go around, trim a bit. Do you know what I mean? Just chop it flat, sort of thing. Might be better to do it with scissors, mate. Yeah, just take a bit there and a bit around the next bit. Doesn't have to go all the way round even, just sort of maybe a couple either side or so.
I think I owe you a large kiss.
Huh?
I think I owe you a large kiss.
I don't want it.
No, seriously, you're going to get it. It comes.
We're trying to show you the spot because I've got 20 euros every time.
It comes breakfast.
Thank you. So the rig works, bait works. You're going to fucking go ask another sit. Thank you.
Hello. It was like £10 bream or something. It's good.
Oh, just a small one,
then. Eh? Yeah, you know.
Yeah, we'll go. Now, how big was it?
37 on the dot.
Yeah. Oh, really?
I was Crusaders doing shit.
When the tail just pinched.
Sure. Like to, and she's yours, isn't she?
Well, that's my one.
She is yours.
Oh,
she's
dead.
Oh, well, I've dropped it. I didn't have it.
Yeah.
I'm going to swap that for 2 Haribo later.
Psst. Thanks.
Do what? Just pulled about that much off. It's too much. Again, I've done it again to you.
Just enough so that when it goes past you, it's flexible.
No, this way.
Yeah, in the swims in heels, that's going to work, isn't it?
Where's
what size are them heels anyway?
How much is your strip
back? Big enough for you, mate.
Should we have a go
like that? He's like, yeah, all right then.
When you do your loop, when you big enough,
yeah,
it sits
give him
inside.
A welcome.
Oh, hello.
I believe. Inside the second boiler. Well, we'll do a really
dark smell nice, aren't you? It smells nice, yeah.
Smell
stop
nice.
Sniffing the woman.
Smell nice, look nice.
Oh, you know why, didn't I? We've just gone into the middle of April, haven't we? So she's had her bath.
Oh. My yearly bath, yeah. Running out
one. Check the clean ones.
No, but they're not proper
cooler
ones, are they?
What are you after?
Hmm? Well,
there's
a knock-off cooler one now.
Don't know, I use the...
Oh, they're new coolers, that's what they are.
Do that.
You just can't...
Yeah, similar to that.
Don't you just...
It's such a great idea having those different sizes. They can change a 16 to an 18 more boiler without changing a rig. No, thanks, I'll do it with these silly things.
Hello, Bigfoot. You're going to want to...
It's all about rig tubing.
Yeah, mate, we need everything the same.
Wow, he's got a box just for his boiler socks.
I don't even use them. Never have.
He's a bit of twig.
Well, no, it's a bit of tubing, old tubing. Cut it in half again.
Where are you going?
Goes flat on the bench.
Hello, sunshine. Yeah. Give me that nose.
Why should you go there? How far is it from?
Yeah, right, but probably about 5 minutes. By the time he's done the knot and tied it, it gains a little bit usually.
You
want to make sure you keep that on the back, down the spine. And then bend away from the. Can you see where the hook's?
Yeah.
See, it's bent that way, round there like that, pushed in there.
What there?
Just psychological for me.
Yeah. Where are you going?
But I would wrap that way. I'm wrapping over the. The hook does that at the back, it goes like that.
Yeah,
you watch it. It's up right like that, and then round that way, and then join there.
Right.
So when I go through the eye, when I wrap it, I wrap it around that bit.
Gotcha, mate.
Because remember that, there's always a bit that if that eye...
Where you going? Yeah,
I'm free, you know what I mean? So I wind it backwards.
Oi!
I'll do about 10 reps or so.
Level with a point, is it?
You want
a
fishy? Yeah,
something like that. Right.
Come over here with the fishy.
Again, the same way, back through the bank. Right.
Yeah, over here, mum. What's in there?
Goodies!
No.
Oh,
yeah, wash that.
Where's the tank? Put it in the tank.
Yeah, we've got a tank.
Do you have your sort of hook sitting up, then? I have the hook flat normally all the time.
I do normally, but I done it last night for him and it was like that. It sat like that.
Yeah.
Exactly like that. And I thought, you know what, that looks well tasty.
Yeah, it's still nice like that.
That
might
be a little bit longer.
You should go last
night. Yeah,
see how they change it? If they sat down today, yesterday, I had to cut the white pop up down.
Yeah, if you chop the bottom bait down, though, it would lift it up slightly.
Yeah, but what I'm saying is the difference in the same rig,
same boilies,
same sizes, yet today. The hook's flat on the floor yesterday, it was popping up and I led it here.
A pop-up's never going to be the same.
Do you know what I mean? So I had to start cutting them down.
Take that.
Because if you cut the white down, I think it sits onto the yellow bar, it comes into more like a snowman rather than two balls sat on top of each other. Mm. Comes like that, do you know what I mean? It's one unit, so to speak. That's just me, but I should make that a little bit shorter.
Yeah, I quite like the hook sat on the floor.
I normally have it on the floor, mate.
Yeah.
I must admit, but I thought because it's a bit weedy out there, it sat right. A couple of those bits of nuggets on there, that should sit down there like that. Then that hook was literally about a mil off the floor. It's absolutely neutrally buoyant.
Each way, it works ideal. But personally, flat, so you know it's laying on its side.
It would be sat like that normally.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah.
That's how I do mine normally. Sat like that.
Exactly the same.
Just a hook dead flat on the floor.
Mm. I've got one out there, it's exactly like that. It sits damn flat, like. But the pop, obviously, everything sits up.
Isn't it?
I think the only problem with it sitting up a little bit is if it dinks on gravel or stuff.
But I think you've definitely got that more movement.
Well, yeah, because there's more
actually floating, it's not actually on the floor.
Yeah.
Potentially, I suppose that's becoming a bit like a wafter.
It depends how far a gap you have from the hook, though. If you have a little bit larger gap, then the actual bait can waft. Without the hook wafting, do you know what I mean?
Yeah, I'm with you, it makes sense.
Therefore, because if the hook's wafting, he's got more chance of grabbing a stick or grabbing something else, you know, that kind of thing. The bivvy. I've made up a few sticks ready for a bit later on, or maybe in a minute. It's red hot, and normally middle of the day the bite's not happening, so I'm considering reeling the rods in. I'm going to bait up the spots that I've kind of been using regular and putting a bit of baiting on. And what I'm considering is taking two rods and going for a wander around the side and just having a look for some fish, see if I can see anything happening, and doing a little bit of margin stalking. So some little sticks, little traps, a few little broken boilies, just real tiny one, just for an hour or two, and just fish margins over on the other side where the sun's really beaming down, the wind's kind of not on there, it's some real sheltered bits. I might have a little wander around, have a look up and down, and just like I say, a couple of rods, one either side, down left and right margin, real close in stuff, and see if I can pick off a fish like that, taking my lines away from my normal baited areas. And obviously I'll go around, I'll probably put in a little bit of bait, a few boilies, a few broken boilies back on them spots, and just leave them to have a free munch basically, and then fish margin style. So I think that's going to be my plan. I'm going to get myself together, sorted out, and we'll have a wander around. I
take the camcorder and the camera. I don't want to take too much, I want to just kind of keep it nice and easy and just sit on the floor over there. See if we can just sit and be quiet and just see if I can have any luck that way. Oh, near the bells in the background. So yeah, that's my plan at the moment. Cause like I say, midday just hasn't been happening by the seams of it. And it's like I say, it's warm today now, it's really hot. So I'm gonna go and do that for a couple of hours, see if that works, leaving the spots free, free grub on them spots. And then tonight, obviously I'll go back onto my spots and see how it works. Say tonight, 4 o'clock, bite time at the minute, seems to be about 5, 6, 7 o'clock-ish, so I'll have them out about an hour before that's all time. So I'm all sorted and settled and everything's relaxed, ready for hopefully a whacker, or just one of any size. Yeah, that's the plan, and I'll catch up with you in a sec once I'm sorted. Thank you. last one. And I am stalking. Only two rods close into the margin, which is why I'm speaking really quiet, and I hope this comes out. I've only been here about 15 minutes or so. There's been no action or nothing like that. But the sun is still really warm, really nice and warm. And I've got them real close to the bank. Just literally dropped them in, walked back. Tiny little stick on each. And just probably about 10 baits. A couple of full ones and some half 18 millers. Just flicked in and around the area. On the right rod, I've got a little snowman rig, which is an 18 mil golden balls. And one of Yoda's special red spheres. Sits lovely, it's just nice. It's just under a little tree to my right. To the left is a double bottom bait, and it's Infusion Baits, pink, I think it's a Cocoa Nuts, and a brown snatch bottom bait. Sort of 14 millers, I think they are, 15 millers. Again, like I say, both little castaway sticks with little bits and bobs in it. And again, 10 baits, a few broken up, just thrown around it, just under a little tree to my left. The sun's beaming on this bank, and I'm just hoping that a different line lay, it might be a little less obvious, little trap, but hopefully I can pick one up. I'm going to give it here for about an hour or so, just sit here quietly, watching the lake from this side. Like I can see straight down the lake. I'll spin you around. You've probably already seen a bit of the footage if I've edited in that way. But also I'm going to go a little bit further down, up near the corner, and do exactly the same thing. I've got a couple of sticks with me, ready to go. I'm sitting on a bucket that's got the boilies in, which obviously before I even came I glugged in loads of amino juices. So I will give this a little go for a while, and then I'm going to walk further up the bank and do another hour or so up there. Being half past one, middle of the afternoon, not really bite time. It's not to say I can't nick one out close in and maybe kickstart my campaign. I will, when I leave here, I'm going to add a little bit of bait to the spots that I'm fishing regularly. I'm not too far actually from the spots I am fishing. Well, the right one is more or less in the spot that I have been fishing regularly, but I'm casting to this one from my swim. Whereas here I can literally drop it right under the trees and it's right, like I say, right close to the bank. So I'm giving that a go, but when I leave I'll put a little bit more bait in here. And I have been baiting up down into the left hand corner. I haven't fished it yet, it's the first time I put a bait anywhere near it. And I've just been, every day I'm just going to keep dropping some bait in there. If I see fish start to move in there, or some movement, or some jumping or anything like that, then again I can come round and stalk it, or I can cast over from my swim and put one over there. I'll move up in a little while, but I'll record that. But it's nice just to actually sit back and concentrate a little bit on my own fishing, rather than socialising with the boys and not really watching my water, which I do a lot obviously, because I'm trying to record everything and capture how good it is here as us as a group. Sometimes I feel that maybe my fishing suffers a little because of that. So, you know, a couple of hours a day in the afternoon, just coming around with a couple of rods. Just doing a little bit of margin stuff, you know, nice and quiet, sit out of the way for a couple of hours, watch the water, and like I say, hopefully I can pick up a fish or two. So, we'll see how we go. Cool, I look, yeah, I do look sleepy, bags, oh. Need to have a shower soon as well. So the right hand rod on the snowman rig. So this overhanging bush, which is what I'm fishing to anyway from my swim, I am right underneath there with the right hand rod at the minute. Got the net in between, nice and easy access, doesn't matter which rod goes off. And then the left hand rod is just there, and that is just underneath this overhanging here. I mean, it looks like the rod's right on top of it, but it's not. There's a good 3-4 yards to the actual spot where I've put the bait in, and it's just the tip overhanging the water. And that's a spot that I've kind of been putting a bit of bait in down in this corner. I haven't fished it, but like I say, when I move up, I'm going to put a bit more bait in both of these spots, and I'll move up and fish up further up. And then about 4 o'clock or so, I'll redo all the rods, get them back on the spots. I'm ready for the evening. But just sitting here, looking out over the lake, I mean, look at them colours there, it's immense. It's my bivvy there, with one side open. See the van, swims 2 and 3, you can just make out the brolly and chalky. I've got the extra long, well, I put the zoom on, super zoom, gets a little bit jerky, but I can not touch the camera, should even out a little bit. I can hear them all having a little socialising chat. Back of Roy's bivvy there, little madam. So I can see on the zoom it's not the best quality. Anything over times 20 can be a bit pixelated and a bit of quality loss. I hope you're getting all the bird song that you can hear. It's just lovely. Sit here in the quiet, listen to the birds, watch the water, look at the scenery. Really is what fishing is about. Peace, tranquility. Yeah. And then you have that peace and tranquility, hopefully disturbed by moments of not panic. What am I looking for? I don't know. Excitement, nerves. That's what we're waiting for. A clicking of that reel, the movement of the line. Going down there in a little while. Nice and quiet, nice and slow. See if we can see anything moving about. If not, we'll just plant a couple of rods in a couple of nice looking spots. Give that another hour or so. Let's try out the zoom. There's the far corner. See how far this zoom goes. yeah, quality's not great. Thank you. I didn't see what the time was. What's the time? 5:45?
Yeah, about that. It is 5 to 6
on Monday. Monday? We still on Monday?
Monday night, mate.
And dinner is served. Looking good. Lovely jubbly tea. Yes. And bread, I believe, under the other ones, if everyone's wondering what the fourth plate is.
But that was on my tray, so I mean, I think that's mine.
Oh, you can't eat all that. I'll end up eating all yours anyway.
Not having any chips, mate.
Right, dinner time. So it's 20 to 9, look at it, Monday evening.
It's been so many shaped the eggs.